Welcome to Hot Copy. Now, one in every 500 children in the Philippines has a cleft lip or cleft palate. Approximately 4,000 children are born with a deformity every year, but one group seeks to change the situation and make children happy by enabling them to perform the basic act of smiling. Here's a look.
A child's smile is a precious thing, but every 3 minutes a child is born with a cleft, a facial deformity that makes them often unable to eat, speak, socialize, or smile. In many cases, their families cannot afford to give them the surgeries they need to live a normal life. For 30 years now, Worldwide Children's Charity Organization Operation Smile has been helping bring smiles to thousands of Filipino children by conducting free reconstructive surgeries. Founded by American couple Dr. Bill and Kathy McGee, in 1982 the group carried out its first mission in a small village in Naga, Camarines Sur. Since then, with the help of dedicated medical volunteers, it has provided over 200,000 free surgeries for children and young adults born with cleft lips, cleft palates, and other facial deformities in 60 countries. This month, the group kicks off its year-long anniversary celebration with a smile run in Manila and Davao City. The event aims to raise public awareness and generate funds for the group's operations next year. Today, Operation Smile continues its mission to transform lives one smile at a time.
Now joining us on Hot Copy are Dr. William McGee, Executive Chairman and Co-Founder of Operation Smile, and Kathy McGee, President and Co-Founder of the organization. Good day to you both.
Great to be here.
What a pleasure to have you here. I mean, this is amazing work you guys are doing. Where did it all begin?
I think it begins in your heart. Mm-hmm. I was one of 12 kids, so chaos never really bothered me too much. Uh-huh. And with a dental and medical degree, I always wanted to take care of children. Mm-hmm. In my practice, Kath has a pediatric nursing degree and a couple of master's degrees that are headed that way. Mm-hmm. And so when we were given an opportunity in 1982 to come to the Philippines to take care of children with clefts, I was a young plastic surgeon. I'm still a young plastic surgeon. And I thought it'd be a great idea. Mm-hmm. But I never expected, nor did Kath, nor did the 13-year-old daughter at the time, Bridget, mm-hmm. ever expect to see what we saw. And when we landed in Naga, and 300 children and their families were waiting for us, mm-hmm. and every one of those parents tugging at our sleeve and begging us to take care of their child, mm-hmm. and we could only take care of 40 kids, watch the others have to be sent away, mm-hmm. nobody there to take care of them, nobody coming back, mm-hmm. It was emotion that really led us to say, let's get a group of our friends, mm-hmm. and go back. Uh-huh. Take care of those kids, the world will be wonderful, our guilt will be gone, we'll go back to our lives as usual. So that's where it began. Uh-huh. And it began in your heart.
Right. And this has been a journey for the past 29, 30 years.
Yeah.
You guys are, honorary citizens of Naga. Yeah, I mean, you have been back and forth. What keeps you coming back?
Definitely the kids. Mm-hmm. Definitely the medical teams that join us here. You have great medical people. But just let's say there's 70, 80 plastic surgeons in a population of 80, 85 million people. Mm-hmm. It's just not enough.
All right.
So the drive is, when you have that many children in front of you that you can change their lives, why not?
All right.
You give them a life in 45 minutes to an hour and a half. You take them from just never going out of their homes, mm-hmm. not able to eat, mm-hmm. they can't speak,
yeah.
they get ear infections, and then their hearing goes, mm-hmm. and they have a facial deformity, so it doesn't matter where you live in the world, people reject you.
Right. That's what I wanted to talk about. I mean, how important is it really to fix a deformity like a cleft palate or cleft lip? Many people go through their entire lives without Thank having the condition addressed, and yet they're able to, live a full life, so to speak. But then full lives is a sort of a very loose term, because obviously it's important to address something like this. It's not just a deformity. It can lead to other medical problems, like you said, malnutrition, not being the least of them. Why is it so important to address?
One out of every 10 children die that have a cleft lip before the age of one because of malnutrition.
So it's a serious thing.
Yeah, and if you have a big hole in the roof of your mouth, you can't suck. So let's say if breastfeeding or even bottle feeding, mm-hmm. is your primary mechanism, mm-hmm. of health, and you can't suck, well, that puts you at a serious deficit, right, for starters.
Right. So this goes way beyond just appearances. I mean, this is something serious.
It's just not a cosmetic thing. Mm-hmm. It's a functional, everyday life thing that keeps you in your hut. You never have a life. You don't have a person in your community that can function ever for the, for their country.
And, you know, but for the lack, as Cass said, of an operation of as little as 45 minutes, you relegate an individual to be an invalid.
Right.
It must be worse than being dead because, I mean, you're essentially tortured in your own body.
Right.
And when we saw that and we think, well, we know how to take care of this. We have buddies who know how to help us. So why don't we go back? The thing that we didn't understand was how big an issue it is. I think there's 95 million people now in the Philippines. Let's say there's 90 million. And so let's say with that, if one in 500, you're talking about 180,000 people with clefts. Well, there's just no earthly way for the manpower here to do it. And I think the blessing of the Philippines was that, as everybody knows, the Filipinos are known for their hospitality, their warmth, their gregarious nature. They welcome you.
Right.
So when we came, it wasn't just as medical professionals. We had a great time and saw a beautiful country and beautiful people. Had we not been given the privilege to go a little deeper into Naga, where we met peasants who came to us who had never had a chance to have this taken care of, we would have never seen this.
Right.
Every place we would have turned our cameras, beautiful kids be coming up, we'd go home. What's the Philippines like? It's beautiful. But I think the beauty of the Filipino people is that because they welcomed us so much, because we had such a good time, there was no logical reason not to come back and help them. And so we brought our friends brought their friends brought their friends, and today we're in 70 countries. And it's been the essence of viral organic growth that everybody talks about today.
It really does warm the heart when I hear people talking about the Philippines in such positive terms. What causes the condition? Is this something that you can avoid? Is this something that people can address before, obviously before it becomes a problem? Is nutrition during pregnancy something that...
Definitely is a genetic link, but the we're seeing just through research now over the years, there's a definite nutritional link. No B6 in the diet, no folic acid in the diet, and minerals. So, you know, we encourage that on our teams. We have high school students on every team that actually teach nutrition and gather all these kids and their families and tell them what, not 8 cups of rice a day, but you've got to have some protein and some vegetables with that. And so, you know, they're able to do that, and even in your rural areas, planting green vegetables and, you know, make them healthier.
All right.
So it's a big part of it, and we're trying to actually teach that now.
Okay. Operation Smile is about helping kids, but is this condition something that you can treat even in adults? Is it is there an age limit to when you can treat the condition?
There's absolutely no age group that you can't treat it in. I mean, imagine, let's say, if you're a teenager or you're in your 20s and you've never been able to speak intelligibly in your life. Nobody could understand you. And in an operation that takes, let's say, an hour, hour and a half, all of a sudden you have intelligible speech. What a gift that must be to give to somebody. And I think that when we've taken care of three generations of people, we've taken care of a grandmother, a mother, and a child, all in the same shot. We've taken care of plenty of people in their 50s, 60s that have never been able to have this repaired. So, you know, obviously it's ideal to get it early. And obviously the earlier you get it, the more the child is self-confident and able to proceed. So our goal is to reach everybody, though.
We do try to focus on those younger ones that, you know, could then start school if they had this surgery and, you know, sort of start life on the right track.
Okay. A big part of what you do is not just correcting, you know, physical appearance and such. You know, you notice that there's such a positive trickle down, so to speak, from when the condition is fixed for a child. It affects their family, it affects the community in such a positive way. What are some of the stories that you can tell us along those lines?
Well, actually, interesting, just a few years ago, we did our 25 years here, and of course, our team here brought some of the testimonies of people. And so, you know, we have a teacher now who had a huge tumor on his chin, mm-hmm. could never do anything. Now he's a teacher, and he gets his group, his teaching, to get these kids to give back. Mm-hmm. So, you know, like, it's still trickling forward, even with his students. But the last child, a 10-year-old, then came up and said, "Let me tell you about my life." Mm-hmm. And they were like, "Oh, gosh, she's only 10. And so she said, "I had some surgery, but I really couldn't speak, but right. I always wanted to sing." And my mom was so positive, she said, "Just sing." Right. She said, "Well, Mom, every time I do, everybody laughs at me, and so I don't feel good." And she said, "Just sing."
Just do it.
And so then she heard the Operation Smile was coming, and this was in Cebu, actually. And so she said, "I had my surgery, so let me sing for you." Mm-hmm. And she sang so clear. I mean, we were all in tears because, wow, what a life for this child. And now she's 16, mm-hmm. and we've had her in Washington, New York, LA, and hopefully she'll have a career someday. So, I mean, you know, just think about the surgeon who did that and the people who are around her to just give her that life.
Her name is Chadeline. People can go to YouTube and look up Chadeline.
All right.
And it is, I mean, it
I
is
she
remarkable.
She just has her first record out.
Yeah. Right. She was in front of Santo Versace and a whole bunch of people in New York City, a big gala, about 1,000 people. And she's a beautiful, beautiful singer, and she sang, and she had got a standing ovation. So here she has this 20, 30-year-old voice. And this little 16-year-old girl at the time, just last year, and all of a sudden she gets a standing ovation. She says, "Oh, I've never gotten a standing ovation before." She was so 16 at that moment.
It
was just beautiful, the contrast. But that child would have never had a chance to reach her potential without an hour operation.
Right. Mm-hmm. I think you guys deserve a standing ovation for the type of work that you guys are doing. And speaking of YouTube, you mentioned that people who might want to see her could find her there, but you've also pointed us towards this great clip that you have for Operation Smile, where you have a child that you guys have helped in Brazil, if I'm not mistaken.
That's right. We have a great surgeon, David Chung, out of Australia. Mm-hmm. And he's a very talented guy, and he did a little flip movie video thing.
Yeah.
Of this little girl in Brazil, in Fortaleza in Brazil, and it's called Suddenly I See.
Right.
It's to the song, Suddenly I See. Mm-hmm. And so if you punch up YouTube, Suddenly I See, Operation Smile, it's got 1.4 million hits right now. Mm-hmm. It just went boom, viral. And in just a couple of weeks, it was boom, over a million hits. And it is just dramatic because as this little kid sees herself on the flip video, literally the day after surgery, and she essentially says, because she doesn't speak the same language as the surgeon, she says, "Me, you sewed me," and she looks, and then she starts posing it.
I know.
It is the most
We're seeing a bit of that clip right here, right now. I mean, here you see a child who typically has this cleft condition. You can see she's covering her mouth.
Right.
She's embarrassed about it. She uses the doll to smile for her because as much as she'd like to, she probably feels a little conscious about it. Mm-hmm. So this is the condition that most of these children will be starting in. Like you said, you have basically a hole at the top of the roof of your mouth, top of your mouth. Mm-hmm.
And what happens is they can't eat. The food comes out their nose and everywhere, so they never get nourished.
Right, properly.
And so they remain very thin. Mm-hmm. And. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so this is the video that you were talking about, where you have, you know, a child who's obviously a very cute child already, but obviously very conscious about the condition that she has.
And then, you know, it really does just dramatically change that child's life. And as it goes on, you know, people can watch that clip, you actually, to see that child's kind of disbelief.
Yeah, you see it now. This is the day after the operation, you say.
Yeah, but she hasn't seen the flip of the phone video yet. And when she doesn't, and you know what I would suggest to people is download that video or load it and virally just get it out to everybody you can, because our goal in starting the 30th anniversary here in the Philippines is to, in the next decade, make sure no child has to live like this.
Right. And this is the moment that you're talking about here. She's there.
She just sees her face for the first time. And she's just
amazed.
Yeah, and she's putting her head into the video camera to say, "Is that,
is that
me?"
Really,
and
then, is that really
then she
me?
Goes, she actually makes the motion with her hands. Did you sew me? Did you sew me up?
Right.
And then she starts to go into her little cute poses.
You see her smile.
It is just
you
unbelievable. And it is just, you see
like
this whole child
on her face.
Psychic being reborn.
And she's such a pretty girl too.
This is
probably, I don't know, you guys probably never get tired of this feeling when you see kids.
Right.
You know, the change that is affected in their lives by such a simple, or not a simple operation, but a small part of their lives. 45 minutes, you say. Mm-hmm. It's 45 minutes mm-hmm. to give somebody a whole, it's a very basic thing to give somebody a smile, but mm-hmm. it does change their lives in so
sure.
many, many ways.
You know,
ways.
I think, though, you know, the beauty of something like this mm-hmm. is that in this day of viral marketing, in this day of activism, mm-hmm. a lot of people say, well, that's great, these surgeons are doing this, or medical people, but how can I help?
Exactly, yeah.
But the bottom line is, Operation Smile is a humanitarian business. We can't do this without the public. We can't do it without the support of corporations, foundations, and everyday individuals.
Right.
And so, everyday individuals change the life of the communities around them. Mm-hmm. So, in this day and age, imagine if every Filipino said, I'll give 50 pesos mm-hmm. to change a child's life.
Right.
If there's 90 million Filipinos, 90 million U.S. dollars could get a raise. I mean, that's insane. But it would cost so little if everybody just said, let me be a part of that. Let me, for this moment in time, lend a little bit of what I have to change some kid's life somewhere. And I'll never know their name. Mm-hmm. But God knows they'll never forget my kindness. And so, you know, let me just, if people can call the Operation Smile office,
right.
actually, at 811-9739 mm-hmm. or 881-9740. Now, they're not in today because of the holiday. But they could do that. And they can email Bobby Manzano, who's our executive director, and that's just Bobby.Manzano.
There you go. I think we're flashing a few of the details up there. People can get involved in a very direct way. You mm-hmm. can make donations mm-hmm. Straight out. Obviously, there are numbers you can call for a bit more information and options. But you said even something as, go ahead, send us an email straight to my personal email.
Yeah.
We'll hook you up.
You can just send it to me. It's just the letter K, mm-hmm. McGee, M-A-G-E-E, at operationsmile.org.
Right.
Send it to me and we'll get you
involved. We'll funnel it right to Bobby.Manzano at operationsmile.org.ph.
Okay.
And there's so many ways people can get involved. And
you know what I love is the students. We have, just because of our daughter going the first time, mm-hmm. she went back to her school and said, guys, I need your help. And so they got involved. But now we have like 750 clubs mm-hmm. all over the U.S. and the world. We just had, we've conferences every summer. This year we had it in Beijing. 800 students came.
Right. Well, I'm not sure if
the clubs could get involved here.
I'm not sure if this video that we have flashing on screen is related to the event you're talking about. This is China, I believe.
Yeah.
What went on here? What happened
here? This was a mission in China, and Coldplay gave us the rights to use the words to the song
Excellent.
To back up the video.
Excellent.
That's actually on YouTube also. Mm-hmm. And it's powerful because what you really get to see in that video is the emotion of the mothers when they see their children for the first time mm-hmm. after surgery. And it's, you know, it's so graphically there is that relief, those tears of joy that is mm-hmm. the absolute relief that, oh my God, I never thought my kid would ever get, you know, treated or
And you can
normal.
See here we use the best equipment, we bring it or they have it, mm-hmm. but it has to be a standard of care. Mm-hmm. And every medical person is credentialed, so
right.
it's the best of what we can give these children. Mm-hmm.
So you see a mom come in here. Like that and pick up her child and just, you know, immediately life changes for that family.
Oh, that is amazing.
And so, you know, I just think that when people try to say, God, I wish I could do that, mm-hmm. well, you can.
Right.
You
mm-hmm.
can.
Yeah.
I mean, it is simple. Just, man, start the viral stuff going, man. Nobody's better at that than the Filipinos.
Right.
They're just texting
all
their buddies and looking up
true.
To YouTube. You know?
I mean, we can lay claim to, I think, being one of the most savvy users when it comes to the internet and such. But related to that, I mean, you actually wanted people here to realize how much, in a sense, we own Operation Smile, how much, in a sense, we started it all with you. You started it all here. Tell us a bit about how that works. I mean, the Philippines was where it was born, and from here, it spread all over the world.
Well, what we're counting on is to use the platform of the 30th anniversary to celebrate Operation Smile worldwide. And the way that we can do that is to have the 70 countries around the world, the 170 sites that we go to right now, it's all because it started here.
Right.
And so to get these great surgeons, anesthesiologists, nurses to come back, and as a way of saying thanks, to donate their time to help more children here. So we'll do 8 sites next November, simultaneously operate on 1,000 to 1,500 kids in a week.
All right, good stuff. Well, we're going to continue this discussion. It's very interesting stuff. We're going to take a quick break here. And when we return, we'll continue our conversation with guests, Dr. William and Kathy McGee, Hot Copy. We'll be right back.